Hi, I'm personal trainer Lauren Kern.
And I'm Jennifer Stano-David. Today we're going to be showing you 5 different exercises that you can do at home or anytime, anywhere.
The first exercise that we are going to do today is a single leg sit to stand. So Jen is going to stand in front of the chair. I'll hold it to make sure it's stable. She's going to lift one leg and she's going to hold that leg all the way up for the duration of the exercise. Jen's going to sit down using her left leg and stand all the way back up again, pushing through her glutes. Good. There you go. Now, if this exercise is too difficult to do in the beginning, then you can just follow Jen and slightly push off with your hands. The goal is to be able to eventually do this exercise with no hands. There you go. Perfect. You just want to make sure that the left knee never goes past the left toe. The chair usually helps you to maintain proper posture. Good. Let's just go for 3 more for a total of 15 reps. 3 and 2. And relax. Then Jen is just going to switch sides and repeat this exercise for 15 more reps. Let's move on to our next booty exercise. All we need is an exercise mat. So Jen, we're just gonna lay down on our back. We're gonna hug one knee towards our chest and the other foot is gonna be flat on the ground. Now holding this knee, we're gonna press our hips all the way up towards the ceiling and back down again.
I've never done this one before, just so you know.
You've done a variation
of it. So let's see how easy this is. I have done a variation of it. Okay, so 1 foot flat.
Uh-huh. Other knee to your chest.
Here. And I'm holding it.
You're holding it. Push your hips up, squeeze your tush, and all the way back down again. Good. 15 to 20 reps.
It's actually easier than I thought.
Great.
I do feel it.
And 4. So you're pushing up using the back of your leg and your butt. The second variation of this exercise is one that we can use our medicine ball for and both legs. So we're gonna lay on our back. Both knees are bent and feet are on the ball. Hands are at our sides. And we're gonna press all the way up and all the way down. This requires a little bit more stability than the primary exercise. But it's also a little bit easier because you get to use both legs. So, we're either going to do 25 reps with both legs using the ball or 15 to 20 reps single leg variation. Let's move on to our next exercise. So Jen has been working hard today, so I'm going to give her a little break and take over. So our next exercise is going to be a lat pull using your exercise band. This time we are going to be in a plank position. There's a lot going on in this next one. So I just slip knotted the exercise band around the bottom of a chair and Jen's helping me to keep that chair stable. Now I'm going to pull myself back until I feel tension on the band. I'm going to put myself in a plank position. I'm going to extend my arm and pull down using my lat. Once again, you want to try to keep your hips nice and still. And because this exercise requires so many different muscle groups, I'm going to ask that you only try for 10 to 15 reps on each side. So once you finish 10 to 15, switch arms.
And just for a little bit of encouragement, this is something I can do. So, it means everybody else can do it.
All right. Now let's move on to our next exercise, the dumbbell squat to alternating military presses with rotation. All right, I'm gonna have you set up with your feet straight ahead, and they're gonna be a little bit wider than your hips. You're gonna hold your dumbbells with your palms facing forward in a military press position.
Okay.
Now, I want you to tap the chair by squatting. Stand all the way up, you're gonna rotate and punch. You're gonna come right back to center, sit, and rotate and punch. Good, now let's just keep on repeating this. So this exercise is great for working the glutes, the quads, the hands, also the fronts and sides of the shoulder, the tricep, and we get a little oblique action during that twist. This looks great. All right, Jen, let's just go for three more. Just a total of 15 reps on each arm and 30 squats. Yes, good, give me some power. And once again, very important to keep the knees behind the toes during the squat. You're doing a great job. All right, last one. And relax. Let's move on to our last ab exercise today. Exercise for today is going to recruit our lower abdominals. So let's start some knee hugs. I'm gonna put you flat on your back. And you're gonna tuck your tailbone, bring your knees into your body and hold. And then extend your legs until they're just about 2 inches from the ground. And hug, and extend. Nice squeeze with the lower abdominals every time. Hug, extend. Now, if this exercise puts too much pressure on your lower back, then there is an easier way to do it, and that's just by using one leg. So, in this instance, we're gonna hold one leg 2 inches above the ground, and squeeze one knee in, and then we're gonna switch. Now every time you switch, you wanna pause for about 3 seconds and just focus on tightening up the lower abdominals. All right. So if we're doing the bilateral variation, using both legs at the same time, then we're going to repeat 25 repetitions. Otherwise, if we're doing the single leg variation, 25 reps per side. All right, so our circuit today included our single leg sit-to-stands, 15 reps on each leg, followed by our glute press-ups, which we did 25 of with both legs, or 15 to 20 with one leg. Then we follow that up by doing our single arm TheraBand lat pull downs in a plank position, 10 to 15 reps on one arm, and then switching. And then we did our dumbbell squat to presses for 15 reps on each arm for a total of 30 squats. Then we wrapped with our last exercise, our knee hugs, 25 reps if you're using both legs, or 25 reps on each leg if you are alternating. So that concludes today's circuit, which you will repeat for 2 more sets.
So make sure you check back next week for video 7 out of 10 for home workouts that you can do anytime, anywhere.
See you next time.